Okay, I hope you can see my screen. I think you can. I can see it in one of the windows here. Okay, great. So we can, I assume we can begin since we have only 1 hour. So let's get started. All right, everyone. So a very, very warm welcome to all of you and a very good morning. And my name is Bharti from Illuminations. And before I begin, I will just tell you a little bit about myself and what I do and why you should, you know, be listening to me for the next 1 hour. So basically, I'm a clinical hypnotherapist. I also do a lot of work with the mind. So I do hypnotherapy, I do a lot of corporate trainings, I work with beliefs, I work with your energy body, a lot of work with the subconscious mind, different, you know, areas of growth for children as well as parent, conscious parenting, a whole lot of these areas is what I usually work with. And the topic that we've got today to, you know, just work together is how to tap into the power of your own mind for more positivity in life, for more productivity, to be more creative. Basically, how can you really go about making your life meaningful to what you truly like it to be and how to achieve the best of it? So I welcome you all to ask any questions that you would like to ask as a group. I believe people here are scheduled in groups. So if you have any question as a group or if you have a, you know, question yourself, feel free to put it in the chat box. And if you like, you know, I can always unmute you and then we can have a discussion as well. So I'm gonna start off with, okay. I think because it's being projected, the it's resounding somewhere. Are you all able to hear me, please? I hope that's clear. Just a thumbs up would do. Yes, okay. Perfect, because there was just a lot of resounding noise that just came in right now. So I hope everyone's comfortable. If there is any problem, I've got the chat box open. Just feel free to put a message there if you can't hear or see the screen or anything like that. Okay, so let's go straight into our plan for today. So I'm going to talk to you about the mind today, and I'm going to talk to you, and not only talk to you, I'm going to share with you some very interesting tools on how you can work with the mind to make things happen for you. Okay, the mind is a very, very commonly used word. We hear it all the time. We so many times hear the conscious mind, the subconscious mind, and what it means for us, right? So I'm going to share with you a brief understanding of the mind, and then following that, I'm going to share with you very, very simple tools. And if you start following those tools or if you start to implement them in your day-to-day life and processes, within, say, 3 weeks, you will be able to find that you are much more aware of the way your mind functions. You are much more aware of whether you can focus and concentrate or whether you keep getting distracted. You will be much more aware of where you are actually manifesting things in your life. Okay, so these are very, very well thought out of tools and want to share with you so that you can share it forward and, you know, going forward from this. So what is the mind? The mind is basically a ball of energy, and I'll come to that. It is a very, very powerful force. It can completely get you going. It can get you motivated, or it can completely enslave you, which basically means that it can take you into a very dark space. It can take you into a very unmotivated space. So whatever you are feeling typically is what's going on in your mind. Where is your awareness going in your mind? And it all boils down to that. Okay, so when we become aware that everything we are feeling, good or bad, is happening because of what we are thinking, what we are choosing to focus on, the whole helplessness from life or the whole feeling of I don't know how to do it goes away. Everything becomes in your own control and charge because you know how to work with the mind, right? So everything that is created in life, it begins in the mind. take a moment to just reflect upon your own experiences, whether something you're going through which is great, whether something you're going through which is not so good, whether something you're going through which is a struggle, whether something you're going through which is a breeze, whatever it is that you are going through in life, be it in your work, be it in your finances, be it in your relationships, whichever area it is. What you think about it is key. If you have a certain thought pattern, your experiences will always reflect that thought pattern to you. Okay? So everything that is going on in your life is actually created in the mind before anywhere else. So how does this work? This basically, now what I'm saying is that your outer world, every experience is a reflection of your inner self. Now, what does this exactly mean for you on a day-to-day basis? What this means on a day-to-day basis for you is that all your beliefs, all your thought patterns, all your daily internal talk, you must be aware that through the day, as we go along our work, as we go along doing our things, there is always this chatter which is going on in the mind. Even when you go for a shower, even when you are doing something in the kitchen, even when you're just sitting at school, when you're sitting somewhere, there is always an inner chatter that is going on. Now become very, very aware of this inner chatter, because this is not random. If this inner chatter is motivating, if this inner chatter is uplifting, it's doing a good job for you, it's directing you, it's motivating you. But if this inner chatter constantly tells you, I'm not good enough, or this inner talk is constantly pulling you down or judging you, it means you are investing a lot of your energy, a lot of your thoughts in a space that's going to become big for you. And actually, the reason you are thinking like that is because you don't want that. So that's step one. Very, very important to understand that whatever you are experiencing outside is happening because of what you are creating and thinking inside. So our first job is to understand what is it that we really want from life, right? Anybody here, give it a moment, think about it. Feel free to even put it in the chat box if you like. What is it that you feel you are looking for in life? As an average, I do this workshop face to face with many people. And when I do ask them, the key thing that comes out of this question is that we are all on a quest for happiness. And this happiness is defined by everyone in different ways. For some person, happiness means a cookie. For some person, it means a Gucci bag. For some person, it's a Ferrari. And for some person, it's, you know, just travel or whatever. So everyone defines happiness differently. But the end goal, the end result, what we are all searching for is eventually happiness. We feel that if we receive this, it will make us happy. If I get this promotion, I will be happy. If I get this grade, I will be happy. If I get this car, I will be happy. If I get this new toy, I will be happy. Whatever. We keep plunging our happiness to something that we feel it will give us. But eventually, what we're looking for is this feeling of happiness. What research tells us is that happier people are at least 12% more productive in whatever it is that they do. And this number would have only gone up higher as research on such areas has, you know, taken on more mainstream now. Which means that if happiness is what we are looking for, we must be very, very aware of what's going on in our mind, which is not allowing for this happiness in full strength to come. Because why is it that we look for something? We look either because we don't have it or we want more of something, right? So what this means is that whatever is in our mindset, we are still looking for perhaps more happiness through whatever goal that we are looking to achieve in our life. Now, if this is not happening seamlessly for us, if it is not happening with ease for us, if it is something that we are struggling with, what we try to do is we try to change things around. Let me change this project, then it might get better. Let me put in extra hours, then it might get better. You know, so we always try to change outside, or we blame the person. If my team member is more understanding, then I might be more successful. If my boss gives me more liberty, then I might be like that. But what's happening is this is like a defense mechanism. This is like a pattern. This is like a way to kind of find support from outside, which is the long route, which is the tougher way of going things. Because you may change everything outside, but till you change what you are thinking and feeling, the result will keep replicating what's going on in the mind. So if in the mind, I believe it's a struggle, then the experience outside will feel like a struggle. If in my mind, I believe it's a breeze, it's really easy, it can happen, I'm really good at it, then the world outside is going to show me what I believe inside. So this is really, really important. And I'm emphasizing it again and again, because this is the foundation of bringing any transformative change in your life. And it does not matter. Hi, is someone trying to say something? No. Okay, maybe it was just unmuted. Okay, so I hope we're clear so far. Let me just check if there is any. Feel free, guys. Yes, happiness. Thank you. If any other questions, feel free to, you know, just post it here. And I'll keep looking at the question box every now and then. Okay, so now getting into a little bit more concept of the mind, right? So the mind, like I mentioned at the beginning, think of it as a ball of energy. Think of it as a really vast space, okay? And in this mind, your awareness is always floating around. Okay, it goes to various areas of your mind. This mind holds everything, absolutely everything. And when you can become aware of how to utilize your awareness through the power of your, say, willpower, you will be able to shift your awareness to only those areas which you want to grow in your life. Many a times, your awareness gets stuck in areas in your mind which are not conducive for your growth. So it could be a limiting belief like life is a struggle, or I'm not good enough, I don't have what it takes, or you know, the economies are bad. I don't know. There are various beliefs, various patterns that get registered in the mind. And then if we hold our awareness there, we start thinking like that, and that starts growing. The implication of that starts growing in our lives. I'm going to share with you four very interesting concepts here. And these concepts are pretty much the foundation of your understanding of how to work with the mind and how to find that happiness that we're looking for, whatever it may give you. Just give me a second. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to start with thought, because everything in this universe, everything in life, it begins with a thought. It's as simple as that. I will say a word right now, and as I say the word, it will generate a thought within your mind. Now, if I was to say cake, okay, each one of you, depending on what cake you've seen or how you experience cake, will have an image of cake in your mind, right? So you will think of cake, and immediately either you'll think of that cake that you really like, or you'll think of the cake that you don't like, but there will be a thought about cake as I say it. Same, I can say the word mom, I can say the word heart. Today is Valentine's Day. So if I say the word heart, suddenly your mind will go to a thought related to that, right? So whenever everything in the mind, it begins with a thought. Now this thought always has an emotion that generates from it, right? So if I was to say dog right now, and if you love your dog, instantly you will have an emotion of love or longing to meet your dog. Or if you are really scared of dogs, you will suddenly kind of cringe and say, oh my God, I hope there's no dog here. So whenever we think of something, a associated emotion always follows. Whenever this emotion comes up, your energy will start to shift. Now, suddenly, if you are planning a really good weekend and someone was to say, oh no, there's no weekend, there is some new project that's come up, instantly the thought will be like, oh my God, my weekend is ruined. The emotion will be like, this is so sad. And because you are now feeling sad, you will feel the dullness in your energy. You will feel a density in your energy. You will feel bogged down, right? And when this happens, it eventually affects your physical body as well as your physical reality. What this means is that every thought has an emotion, when we hold this emotion for a long time, this emotion starts to interfere or starts to influence the way our energy is. And then as this energy becomes a certain way, it becomes kind of pegged in a certain way, it starts to dictate or starts to influence how things unfold in our physical body as well as our physical reality. When I say physical body, take the simple example of a very, very hard or tough day, I'm having a headache, or I'm feeling very, very stressed and my eyes are hurting or my neck is hurting because I've had a very troublesome day. Now, because of this troublesome day, the kind of thoughts, the kind of emotions that I'm carrying is bogging my energy down, and this is imprinting in my physical. And have you ever noticed that whenever you feel you're having a really tough day, other things around also start going not so great? For example, you're rushing to get to a meeting and you're already thinking, I'm late for the meeting. And then you get stuck on the slowest lane, maybe on Sheikh Zayed Road. Maybe the lift just does not come when you want it to come, right? So whatever we are thinking, it's influencing the energy. And then that energy starts playing up and starts altering what's going on around us. Okay, so remember this in like absolutely every experience that's happening, that you have a choice. If something is not unfolding the way you want it to, by changing the thought or by changing the way you feel about it, you may be able to alter what's unfolding for you in front of you. And this is really powerful because this can take you from a place of being helpless to being in the driver's seat of your life. And eventually, that's what we all hope for, that we are consciously creating things in our life that brings us happiness, right? Any questions here, feel free. I like to usually make this workshop very interactive, but I understand that on the webinars, it gets a little bit difficult. But if anyone has a question, feel free to post it. Or if anyone has any comment, feel free to post it as well on the chat box. Okay, so I'm going forward from here. So I'm hoping that you have kind of got the grasp of what I was talking about, the thoughts, the emotions, the energies, and your physical body as well as physical reality. This is a very interesting model of the mind. Too less time, and I'm not going to discuss it in detail, but I just wanted to show this to you because it will give you a good idea to understand how the functioning of this mind really happens. If you look at this, this model is like a ball of energy. It's a circular model. The top part, which is 12%, is what we understand as the conscious mind. Now, all the time in our waking hours, when we are thinking, when we are deciding, when we are feeling, when we are making choices, we are using our conscious mind. We are conscious of things as we are awake. Okay, and this is only 12% of your entire mind. Now, what is the balance 88%? Now, the balance 88% is what we refer to as your subconscious mind. Now, subconscious mind is huge. If you feel that all your thinking, logicking, analyzing, feeling, choices is happening by that 12%, what is this 88% really doing? Two very important things it's doing. One, it is responsible for all our involuntary actions, which basically means that you don't have to consciously remind yourself to breathe. You sometimes consciously remind yourself to breathe deeply when you may be stressed or shallow breath, but you don't have to remind yourself to breathe. You don't have to remind your heart to beat. These are all involuntary actions, which are taken care of by the subconscious mind to keep us alive. So one of the key responsibilities of our subconscious mind is to keep us alive. The second thing our subconscious mind does, and it does beautifully, is that it is a repertoire. It just basically records and stores every experience we've had in life from the moment that we are pretty much conceived to the time that we leave this body. Every experience is stored in the subconscious mind. And with the right kind of trigger, you are able to access that information at any point of time. So it's very, very interesting that the subconscious mind is actually 9 times bigger. It is 6,000 times more powerful than your conscious mind. And it stores absolutely everything that you have experienced in life. Now, when you see on the screen this negative and positive, this is basically not the way we understand negative and positive at a conscious level. At a subconscious level, negative and positive, you can read it as known or unknown. So anything that is a known will always get saved as a positive experience. The only time any experience will get saved as a negative experience is when it is a threat to your survival. Besides that, even a limiting pattern, even a experience which you don't want to repeat in your life will get stored as a positive or a known because that is something that you have done before. So I'm not going to get into the details of this, but I want to, why I'm sharing this is for you to understand that many times consciously, we choose to make certain decisions. I will start going to the gym from tomorrow. I will start eating healthier from tomorrow. I will start, you know, on 31st December, our beautiful long list of New Year resolutions. But come February, and most of these are already withering down. Not for everyone, but for many people, yes, it does happen. What I want you to understand is that this reason why this happens is not because, oh my God, I can't stick to my goals. The reason this happens is because the conscious mind is only 12%. And if you've been repeating a not so healthy pattern, maybe eating junk food or sleeping late or whatever, whatever negative or unhealthy pattern you want to change in your life, but you've been repeating it for a period of time, it is stored in this 6,000 times more powerful space as a positive association. And so therefore, it requires tremendous amount of focus and willpower to be able to shift it and change it. Okay, so that's a very, very base level understanding, but I thought it's important for us to kind of, you know, just get an idea or a glimpse of it. Now, what is the ultimate goal from today? You know, you're spending your time here today. What would you like to achieve from this? It's how to make your mind work for you. And I'm going to share with you some, one moment. I don't know. This is kind of getting blurred here. I'm not sure. Okay. Anyways. So I'm going to share with you 5 simple steps of how you can do this. Feel free to note this down if you like. Step one is if you want to shift anything in your life, step one is finding clarity about it. How do we find clarity? We cannot change anything till we know where we are, right? So if I want to be more positive, if I want more success, if I want more self-confidence, if I want more public speaking skills, if I want more success, whatever I want, I need to first know where I am. Now, how will I know where I am? I will know where I am by knowing what is going on in your mind. So what is your mind creating for you? I've shared these 4 different areas here. Okay, feel free to make a note of these. And in your own time, we have very less time right now, but in your own time, try and put down or maybe just close your eyes and pick up each of these topics and see what are your thoughts about it. Because what you are thinking about these key areas, and feel free to add more specific areas for yourself. I've just put an average of key areas that most people usually, you know, think about in with regards to happiness, with regards to success and so on. Put your thoughts about it. What do you think about your health? Do you feel you are fit? Do you feel you are unfit? Do you feel you have lots of energy to go through the day? Do you feel you're always tired? With regards to your relationships, with regards to the feeling of love in your life, do you feel relationships are tough to manage? Do you feel you have very strict or strong relationships? With regards to your career, your goals, your purpose, what is it that you are thinking? Because what you are thinking is where you are at. And that's what you then need to know how to change it. I've shared some very, very common self-limiting thoughts that I worked with many clients with before. And so I'm sharing this with you because many a times it helps us to associate that, oh yeah, I keep thinking this, or very many times I bring this to my mind, but I do not realize that this can actually have a repercussion, or this can be one of the reasons why I'm unable to really get what I want from life. Okay. Many times we say things like, I'm not lucky enough. Okay, and we don't really mean too much about it that time. We just say it because we say it. Sometimes we constantly believe that I am like this only, I cannot change, or my opinion doesn't matter to the people around me. So if you have any such limiting beliefs, take a moment to think about these, because whatever are these beliefs, you are focusing unconsciously in these areas. And when you focus on something for even for a few seconds and minutes, your energy magnetizes towards it. When your energy goes towards these areas, it makes these areas bigger in your life. And all your experiences then reflect back to you the same feeling that you hold from these beliefs. Okay, it's not a complex concept, but it takes time to grasp it sometimes. But if you grasp it, you will know exactly how to shift what's not working for you in your life. And as humans, we are constantly evolving. Our journey is about, you know, getting better and better, being a better version of ourselves as we go along. So the more we are aware what is getting created in our lives, the more we are aware what we are thinking. And the more we are aware what we are thinking, we can start to change that. So do this exercise for yourself for sure. Become aware of your beliefs. This will give you clarity. This will give you clarity on what you want. When you know what you don't want, you also eventually know what you do want. Step two is, once you have this clarity, once you become clear on what you no longer want to attract in your life, I no longer want to attract this struggle, I no want to longer attract a failure, or I no longer want to attract so much of challenges, then I need to focus on what I truly want. What is my desire? How do I do this? I've broken this down into two very simple parts for you all. Okay. I'm going to share this with you. Yeah. 1 minute. Yeah. So what we can do is, we will start by making a list of your goals. Make a list of your goals, and to begin with, focus on only one, so that you can see how beautifully this works and how effective this is, right? Focus on one goal that you really want to materialize in your life. It could be materialistic goal, it could be improving a relationship, it could be feeling fitter, healthier. I leave that to you. You decide what is that area that you want to really see a shift in. Pick up one, because what happens is, many a times we start working on 10 things at the same time and we are unable to do justice to all of them. And then we don't get success in even one, because it just becomes so big and we get overwhelmed and then we leave it. That's a very typical way how things just get left half done. Okay, so you make a list of your goals, focus on one that you want to work on. Alongside, I also want you to make a list of all the reasons that you truly believe this is hard to achieve, or this is impossible, or this is difficult. Because many a times when we think of what we want, at the back of our mind, we keep thinking, oh, but you know, that won't be possible. I'm not gonna manage to travel by then. I don't think this is happening. I don't think I'll get leave that day. I don't think. So there are 20 thoughts that we also create at the same time when we create that one thought which we want. And I already shared the concept with you that wherever your thoughts are generated, energy goes in that area. So if I'm creating one thought which says, I want to purchase this, or I want to be in this position, but at the same time, I think of 20 things which says, I cannot do it because of, my energy is getting split. We need to focus our energy without letting it split. How do we do that? You make a list of everything now which you feel it can come in the way. Get it out of your system. Why? Because once you put it on this paper, every time your mind tries to take you, it's not possible because of this reason or that reason, you are able to change the association. You simply say something as simple as stop, cancel, delete. So what are we doing? We're creating a new way of thinking. The brain, as you know, is all about neuropaths. Whatever neuropath is constantly, you know, lit up, the more we easily go into that. So if I constantly believe I want something but I cannot get it, the brain is moving a certain way, the energy is moving a certain way, the result is the same. By doing this, we are changing the way the whole chemical reaction and energetic reaction is happening. Now, I've put down all the reasons. I cannot do this because I have to take care of this. I have to take care of that because this. Let that sheet be exhaustive. Once you make that sheet, we simply, why is this not going? Yeah. Once you make that sheet, which is of all the issues and problems and reasons why you feel you cannot achieve what you want to achieve, you tear that sheet and dig it into the ground or flush it. Whatever you want to do, I leave that with you. Okay? You tear that sheet and you do that. Why do we do that? Because energy, as you all know, cannot be transformed, cannot be created or destroyed. It can only transform from one form to another. Now, all the energy of this not happening, not good enough, cannot happen, struggle is being transformed and shifted from my space. Now, I need to focus all my energy on that other sheet in which my goal is there. And now I energize that. How do I energize that? I read it every day. When I read it every day, I think about how it makes me feel. Okay. And as I read it, as I think about it, I feel good. When I feel good, my energy now starts matching that reality. When my energy starts matching that reality, it has to come back to me. It has to. There is no other way of it not, because I've already created that for myself. So which basically means that if you have focus and if you have consistency over a period of time, at least I would say minimum you do this for 21 days. And these are just two steps. I have three more steps to take you through. If you do this process for 21 days, you will be able to find good result in moving towards the direction of what you're really looking for. I want to share with you, just to kind of strengthen what I'm talking about, two very interesting experiments. Some of you may have heard or may have seen results of these experiments. The first one is Dr. Emoto's water experiment. Now, this experiment I'm sharing with you by explaining to you how the power of intention is so strong. Okay, so Dr. Emoto was this very amazing scientist, and he used to work a lot with water. Okay, he used to say that water has memory, and you know, the structure of water then accordingly changes with what kind of vibration it is flowing with. Now, we ourselves, our bodies are more than 60% water, right? So what Dr. Emoto did was he took these three different containers of water, and all the containers were absolutely the same. The condition in which these containers were put is absolutely the same. The only thing different was on each of these containers, he put a certain intention. So on one container of water, the water from the same source, he said love. The second, he said thank you. And the third, he said I hate you. Okay. And then what he did was every day for a period of time, he would go to these containers, look at the containers, focus on it, and repeat what is written. So he would tell one sample, I love you. He would tell the other sample, I'm grateful for you, thank you. And he would tell the third one, I hate you. And he would do this repeatedly for a period of time. After that, when they studied those samples of water under the microscope, you can see on the screen the three different images or the structure of the same water, same source at any point of time. Right? This water was treated in the same way, except the emotion and intent that it received. And if this water, which was in a container, can receive this, you can just imagine the constant thoughts that we have, or the constant words that we speak to ourselves and those around us, the impact it can have on us. And so therefore, our words, our thoughts, our emotions have a lot of impact. If we shift it to an energetic vibration of love or gratitude, more experiences in our life will unfold that will reflect back more love, more gratitude, more success, more abundance, whatever it is that you are looking for, right? So this was an interesting, so be very mindful of what is that internal chatter. And also for those of you who work with kids and, you know, parents and teach, what we speak to them, how we build them with our words can change the way their energy flows as well, right? Okay, the second experiment, again, Dr. Emoto is very interesting. This was the rice experiment. Again, three samples from the same source, three different containers. On one, he said, you're an idiot. On one, he said, gratitude. And one, he ignored, like completely ignored, did not even give it any kind of recognition. Every day, the same samples, same emotion that is typed was spoken to them. The one which was ignored was not even looked at. Over a period of time, what came out was that the one which said thank you had a very nice fragrance to it. It had fermented in the right way. The other two actually had fungus and growth and mold in it, right? Again, coming back to the same point that what we are thinking and what we are putting out there can shift actual matter. This is actual rice, and the three, same temperature, same place, everything same except for the thought and the intent that has been rolled out on it. Okay, so this basically shows us that human intentions, human emotions can actually alter your physical reality at any given point of time. And that power lies within each one of us, whether it's happening unconsciously. That means that we are having these negative thought patterns or not so motivating thought patterns, and it is shifting our life. Or we can do it more consciously. And if we can do it more consciously, we get that much closer to what it is that we want to truly manifest into our own lives. Any questions so far, anyone? Feel free to put it on the group so that I don't want to go beyond. If you know you have any doubt or anything on it, feel free to post it on the chat or to even unmute and ask me if that works, though I do believe it's resounding when you unmute.
Miss, can you hear us?
I'm sorry?
Are you able to hear us? Please talk this
up. Yeah, I can hear you.
Do you have any questions? None so far.
Okay, super. So are we good? Are we good to go on the same pace?
Yes.
Okay, super. Okay, so then we come to the next step. Okay, so now we have the clarity. And we know exactly what we want. Now it comes down to kind of bringing that focus on a more repetitive way in our life. And this goes for everything. The more we do something, the better we get at it. And the same goes for our unconscious negative habits as well. We may be distracted a lot during the day, right? And we are unconsciously practicing that. And so therefore, that distraction becomes very, very prominent in our lives. We may be constantly trying to, multitask or be on the phone while we're doing something else as well. And this becomes habit. And the more we keep doing that, the better we get, at distraction, right? So we need to focus our energy on whatever it is that we want to bring into our life. And then we allow the law of repetition to work for us by focusing on it every single day. At all times, our energy needs to hold the same vibration. I am receiving it. I am achieving it. I am thinking well. I am thinking positive. Whatever it is that you've chosen for yourself, you need to keep repeating that over and over and doing it for a period of time. Okay. How this begins is whenever we start anything new, and not only to change your own perspective of things, or not only to change, it could be absolutely anything. Take driving, for example. Okay. When you just learn how to drive, or you want to learn how to drive, you have unconscious incompetence. Okay, so at this point of time, I am unconscious about driving. I do not know that I have learned driving, and I have no competence about it as well. when I register myself in a school and I start driving lessons, I am very conscious now that I need to start learning how to drive. I need to understand those signals. I need to do everything. So I'm conscious, but I'm still having some sort of incompetence because I've still not got all the skills. I've not practiced as much, right? Taking it further, now I have done my driving school. I have learned, taken all the lessons. I am perhaps even taken my exam. Now I am conscious and I also am competent to drive. I am aware that I have the skills that I need as well as the permit to drive. When I start doing it over and over again, and I've been driving for weeks and months and years, I'm in a space of unconscious competence. Now I could be on a phone when I'm walking to my car, get into my car, put the phone on the car phone, start driving. I don't even have to think about it. But when I was in a space before, I would always get in, I would think, I would adjust my mirrors. As you become more and more and more conscious of something, the competence or the skill set, it just starts following you. You don't have to make an effort for it. But to reach there, you have to first go through the entire cycle. So therefore, repetition is very, very important. The more you keep repeating it, the better we start getting at it. Now, what is step four? Step four is basically your ability to focus daily to energize your goal. You need to set aside some time every day. That's one. And secondly, every time you think about that subject, you need to have the same thought process for it. Okay, this could be through affirmations. You can use a lot of affirmations to help you. If it's something about success, you can talk about, I am successful in XYZ. If it is about receiving some sort of promotion, I am enjoying the benefits of XYZ. If it's good health, my body is healthy and very fit. So whatever your goal is, you create an affirmation. Every time you think about this subject, you bring that affirmation to your mind. You remind your mind over and over and over again not to go into that negative space or not to go into that limiting space, but through affirmations, bring it in. The other thing that a lot of my clients like doing is a gratitude journal. Why? Because like I mentioned already to you, your thoughts, they have power. Your emotions have power. And most interestingly, your subconscious is related to your writing. So writing is a very subconscious activity as well. So whatever you write, you can directly plant in your subconscious mind as well. So when you write some really interesting aspects of positivity, of gratitude, you are also creating a more positive layer in your subconscious mind by doing that. The other thing to do this daily focus is I always tell my clients, the energy with which you wake up and the energy with which you go to sleep is really very important. Because when we wake up in the morning and we are scattered, our whole day goes like that. But if we can actually wake up even 7 minutes before and just ground ourselves and bring our awareness to our mind, set an intention for the day, set a focus for our energy to go in a certain way. You know, whenever we're doing anything, be it a team sport, be it at work, you always have to give instructions to the person who's working along with you, whether it's your teammate, whether it's your partner, whether it's your children, whether it's your students. Until they know what they have to do, they will be scattered. So instruction is very important, even at a very energy level. So when you wake up in the morning, you give yourself that instruction. I am feeling grounded, centered. I am feeling, you know, what is successful, whatever it is that you want to feel, you give your energy that input. Your energy will then run with it. But if you don't give any input, you wake up scattered, you say the first thing in the morning, I'm already running late, today's going to be a crazy day, it's such a chaotic day, your energy will follow suit. It will believe that you want to have a crazy day. It will believe you want to have a very rushed day. It will believe you have no time. So whatever you set for yourself in the morning is very important. Same thing at night. Very often we go to sleep with some sort of either anger, or we go to sleep with some sort of tension for the next day or stress for the next day. That reflects in our dreams. It reflects in the kind of quality of sleep that we have. So even at night, your focus should be on gratitude. Don't think of the 10 things that went wrong at night. Think of those 3 things or whatever number of things that went right. Feel gratitude for it. The minute you express gratitude at night for something, automatically your energy will calm down. You will get better sleep and you will be able to focus more streamlined energy into what you really want for yourself. Okay, so that's your step 4. And then wish list. Wish list is again a way to kind of intend your energy. Whatever goal you chose for yourself, you keep adding things onto that goal to make it more and more real for you. Okay. When I have this, I have this, this, this. So keep adding more and more wish lists on that same goal that you have created for yourself. So this was your step 4. And then step 5 is about constant focus on the intention as a visualization. And I believe we have just enough time to do that. So we will do that visualization right now. I will teach you how you can do it along with breath. And you can start working on it as you like after that. It will just take about 5-7 minutes. And then if we have any questions, we can do that. So let me know if you all are ready to do the visualizing exercise. Let me open the chat box. All I would need from you all is to just sit straight and don't cross your legs anywhere. Just keep your palms as well on the table. I can see somebody's class and yeah, just be seated. Keep your feet on the ground. Don't cross your legs. And just keep your palms on the table, palms facing up to the ceiling. If you guys can do that, and then you can just gently close your eyes if you like. We will do a very quick, short visualization. Once you do this visualization, you will be able to work with this on any area of your life where you would like to manifest something for yourself, how you would be able to shift your mindset on anything that you like. Okay, so let's begin. I want you to just close your eyes, sit comfortably, keep your back straight, and then take your entire focus and awareness to your breath. And we always start with the breath because the breath is the most beautiful and seamless way to tap within. So close your eyes and then take your awareness to a breath. So at this moment, you are not taking any deep breaths. You are not lengthening your breath in any way. You are simply observing your natural breathing rhythm. And then just breathe in and breathe out. And as you are trying to hold your awareness on the breath, you may notice that your awareness begins to wander. It may go on to some thought. It may get distracted by some sounds or noises. It may even get distracted by some kind of judgment or comment from your own mind, and that's natural. The only job you have right now is to hold the awareness on the breath, and every time that awareness moves from the breath, you notice that it has moved from the breath, and you bring it back to the breath. And do that for just another moment. Notice the awareness of your breath. If the awareness moves from the breath, you bring it back to the breath. Visualize this process like a small toddler who keeps coming asking for something. And you are choosing to focus on something which is very important that time. The toddler or the pet will keep coming. You let them know that you will attend to them at another time, and you keep the awareness on the breath. And keep holding that awareness on the breath. Excellent. Now we will do three rounds of very deep cleansing breaths. So what you do, and this helps us every single time to release resistance. So as you now begin to set your intention, I want you to just take three deep breaths where you breathe in through your nose and you breathe out. And once you've done that, three deep breaths, you go back to your natural breathing rhythm. In and out. Breathing in and out. Now, I would like you to think about that one goal that you wish to manifest in your life. Take a moment to just word it in your mind. You can even imagine it like you are writing it on a whiteboard. Once you have this goal in your mind, I want you to allow all your senses to work with it. We'll start with the sense of sight. So I want you to start visualizing, imagining, let all your creative juices work for you here. Visualize yourself experiencing this goal. If it is something that you are looking to achieve, see yourself having that. If it is a relationship, see yourself in that relationship. If it is something you wish to procure, to buy, see yourself owning it. If it is a bank balance, see that amount in your bank account. So use your entire power of sight, of vision, to see yourself experiencing exactly what it is that you wish to manifest. Now, as you see yourself experiencing it, seeing it, we will add some other elements so that every time you think of those elements, you will be able to experience what it feels like to have lived and achieved this goal. So let's begin with, if you were to associate the sound, any sound, with this beautiful experience of living your goal, what would it be? Would it be the sound of bells, your favorite song, the sound of your loved ones, a music, chimes? Bring into your mind space any sound that you feel you can associate and allow that to connect with your goal. Keep seeing yourself living that moment. Allow that sound to be in your mind space. Let's add the senses of smell. So if you were to able to associate any fragrance, any aroma to this vision, what would it be? The smell of your favorite flower, your perfume, your favorite dish cooking, the smell of rain when it hits the earth. Allow it to completely come into your mind space. And the subconscious mind never knows what is real or what is unreal. Whatever you give it, it believes it to be real. So allow that smell to infuse through that entire vision. If this beautiful vision, you could touch it, what would you associate it with? Does it feel soft like a feather? Flowing like water, strong like teak, allow yourself to associate the sense of touch with this beautiful experience. Allow that vision to only get stronger. And if you could taste this experience, what would the taste of achievement, of success mean to you? Your favorite dish? The taste of water? Allow it to all flow into your space. Once again, see yourself experiencing every moment. See yourself living that moment, your body language, the people that surround you, the sounds that you associated, be it of bells or laughter, the smells that surround you, the taste, the touch. And as it all comes together, take a deep breath. Know that your job is done by simply holding this experience and vision in your mind, and then let it go. Slowly take the awareness back to the breath, and then gently rub both your palms together. Place them on your eyes, and then slowly you can open your eyes into the now, bringing that commitment, that passion to your goal, to your world outside. And then come back to your natural rhythm and movement. So simple exercise may seem strange to begin with. There can be resistance, but it is very powerful because we are our thoughts, and our senses are always supporting us with all our thoughts. If we can create this association, and if you can do this regularly, at least 21 days, you will notice new neural pathways get created in your mind space, in your brain, and you will be able to achieve what you're looking for. So yeah, that's pretty much what we had to share with you today. Feel free if you have any questions, or if you have any comments, anything that you may want to share, feel free. You can do so by unmuting yourself or even on the chat box, whatever is more comfortable.
Ms. Nusheen, do you have any questions?
Thank you so much, Ms. Kira. Thank you very much. I'm glad. Hi, Jean. Is there anything you would like to say or ask? Please. You can unmute if you like, or you can ask on the chat. How do we boost it in students? Repetition is the key thing, Jean. You have to break it down. And kids are very, very confident in students. Yeah, so again, completely one, this whole exercise of the water, I work with many children as well. And this water exercise really helps them, especially with low self-confidence, bullying matters and things like that. So if we tell them that what we say to ourselves and what we say to others, with kids, they are very, very temperamental, right? So you say it once, they may not get it. But if it is constantly repeated over and over again, it really helps. Specifically for confidence, if you're looking for exercises, there are some more exercises that one can work with, certain links of daily visualization or certain links of helping them with grounding, constantly helping them with affirmations. If a child is feeling underconfident, help them come up with an affirmation that they can work with at their level, whatever age they may be. And then repeat that affirmation on a daily basis. One exercise I do with many of my clients at night before they sleep, the small ones, even with my own children, is, you know, we do something like we take our fingers and it just helps them to focus their attention. And then we go on to something like peace begins with me. Okay, so even if they are struggling at school with some sort of bullying, or if they're struggling with some sort of friendship issues, you can change peace with anything. Okay, so happiness begins with me, or confidence begins with me. So you pick up and teach them every night to work with their fingers. This helps in two things. One, it helps them to focus. Second, repetition. If they do it 21 times every night, it will really go into the subconscious mind, especially before sleeping. And third thing, the more they practice something, the better they get at it. And so over a period of time, you will see some results in that. I hope that helps. One more question. We're going to come to manifest session to practice. Which part, as in you need the slides for this? Is that what you're talking about? I can put on PDF and share with you the steps. No problem. We can do that. I can pass it on to our team in Dubai and they will share it with you. Anything else? Otherwise, we are out of time. Sure, we will send you the I can put it on PDF and send you the entire thing. Not a problem. Recording, if they have it, I'm sure they can send it. Unfortunately.
Okay, I have a question, Bharti. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, so you mentioned about two things, about gratitude and wish list.
That's right.
Now, if we have a wish list, how can we show gratitude then? Because even we are wishing something, sometimes those wishes may not be realistic. And mm-hmm. they will not let us be gratitude to the things that we already have.
Okay, that's very interesting and very important. And I'm glad you asked that. Gratitude is a space. I have gratitude for everything that I want. But that does not stop me from unconsciously, constantly thinking of lack. I may be in gratitude, but I still often unconsciously may be thinking, oh, I wish I did have that. Once we have something which is a wish list, for example, we are able to put our gratitude into that. And when we say wish list, we always try to write it in the sense that we already are experiencing this, not in the space of lack. Because the way the human mind works, we are always looking for more. We started off like that. We're always looking for more. But if I can put what I want, what I desire for the best in my life, but put it with gratitude, then automatically I'm able to manifest that more into my life. That was the whole idea of that wish list.
Thank you.
Most welcome. Anything else? Okay, I think we are good, and I think we've just about gone ahead of time. Thank you very much, Farah. Thank you, Jean.
Hey, Dr. Bharti, on behalf of the TCSI management and Dr. Frank, our principal, we would like to thank you so much for imparting your knowledge and for sharing us your well-being session today. It's a great pleasure and honor to be having you today as our speaker.
Likewise, our pleasure. Thank you so much from everyone.
We look forward to having more well-being sessions with you and working in collaboration with you in the future.
It will be our pleasure from everyone from Illuminations.
Thank you so much for Ms. P as well for coordinating.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
And of course, our team will be in touch with you. If there's any question or if you want to know anything more, we'll be more than happy to share that with you.
All right, miss. And also, if we can have the recording for this.
Yes, I will ask them to help us with that. Sure.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye. Have a good day.
You too. Bye.
Bye.